Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. This video is the first video of a three-part series concerning the topic of direction. In this video, we will discuss the basic of direction. The second video explains the component of direction. And in part 3, we will discuss grid direction or sometimes referred as grid navigation. Section 1. Basic Concept. Earth is spinning on its polar axis. East is defined as the Earth's spinning direction. Other cardinal direction is determined from the east definition. Opposite to east direction is the west direction. When we are facing toward the east, north is to the left and south is to the right. These are the four cardinal directions used in navigation. Furthermore, we have additional quadrantal directions, which are midway between these four cardinal headings. They are northeast, southeast, southwest, and northwest. Section 2. Sexagesimal System. In aviation, we use the sexagesimal heading system. The direction is divided into 360 degrees and measured clockwise from direction datum. Unlike the decimal system, which is based on 10, the sexagesimal system is based on 60. It is used in angle, time, and latitude and longitude system. Every 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. And every 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. To explain how to convert between sexagesimal and decimal numbers, I will use two examples. First, 10 degree 20 minute. To change it into decimal, take the minute and divide it by 60, which gives us 0.33. Therefore, 10 degree 20 minute is equal to 10.33 degree. Second example, 60.8 degree. To convert this value into degree and minute, we need to multiply the decimal 0.8 with 60, which gives us 48 minutes. Thus, 60.8 degree is equal to 60 degree 48 minutes. This process can be simplified by using a calculator. In this video, I will show how to use the Casio calculator to convert from sexagesimal to decimal and decimal to sexagesimal. For the Casio calculator, this button is known as the sexagesimal button. It controls the conversion between sexagesimal and decimal. (10°, 20 minutes). To convert it into decimal, just press equal and the sexagesimal button. (60.8°). To convert it into sexagesimal, just press equal. Easy. By the way, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new content. Section 3. Determining direction from coordinates. During the examination, you need to be able to determine the direction from two sets of coordinates. In this video, we will discuss how to determine direction from the given coordinates. North and South direction. First, we will look at how to determine whether the direction given by two sets of coordinates is northerly or southerly. To determine north or south direction, you need to use latitude. As you can see, from the equator toward the north, the latitude value is increasing. The same happens from equator toward the south. the south latitude value is increasing. If we are moving from 30 degree north to 60 degree north, we know that we are moving toward northerly direction because the north latitude value is increasing. The opposite will happen if we are moving from 60 degree north to 30 degree north. We are moving in a southerly direction because the north latitude value is decreasing. The same condition applies to the southern hemisphere. Moving from 20 degree north to 30 degree south, what is the direction of travel? To reach 30 degree south from 20 degree north, the value of north latitude is reducing and the value of south latitude is increasing after we pass the equator. Therefore, the direction is southerly. An easier way to determine direction is by sketching the relative position. East and west directions. Determining easterly or westerly direction is more important compared to determining northerly or southerly direction. You need to determine easterly or westerly direction to successfully answer great circle and most of the chart question. As you can see, the value of easterly and westerly longitude increases as the line is further away from the prime meridian or 0 degree longitude line. If we move to the right, the value of westerly longitude is decreasing and the value of easterly longitude is increasing. When we move from left to right, we said that we are moving in an easterly direction. If we move to the left, the value of easterly longitude is decreasing and the value of westerly longitude is increasing. When we move from right to left, we said that we are moving in a westerly direction. If we take antimeridian as the center of the map, longitude line will look like this. The easterly longitude is on the left and the westerly longitude is on the right. However, moving from left to right, the value of easterly longitude is increasing and the value of westerly longitude is decreasing. We are still moving in an easterly direction when we move from left to right, even though the position of east and west longitude is in reverse near anti-meridian. The same is true when we move to the left. We are traveling in a westerly direction. On the screen is two sets of longitude. I will use this longitude to demonstrate three methods to find easterly or westerly direction. 30 degree west to 30 degrees east. To find the direction, we can draw the relative position between these two positions. If this is prime meridian, 30 degree west is to the left of the prime meridian and 30 degree east is to the right of the prime meridian. Moving from left to right, we are traveling eastward. 150 degree west to 150 degree east. For this route, we need to use anti-meridian as the basis, because traveling through anti-meridian is closer compared to traveling through the prime meridian. 150 degree west is to the right of anti-meridian and 150 degree east is to the left of anti-meridian. Traveling from right to left, we are traveling westward. The second method is by measuring the changes in longitude value. 30 degrees west to 30 degrees east. As you can see, the west longitude value is decreasing and the east longitude value is increasing. Thus, we are traveling to the east. 150 degree west to 150 degree east. As you can see, the west longitude value is increasing and the east longitude value is decreasing. Thus, we are traveling toward the west. Another method to determine direction is by drawing the longitude based on a polar stereographic chart. Only use the north polar stereographic chart to determine the direction. The south polar stereographic chart will give wrong result. This circle will represent the Earth viewed from the top. The middle point of the circle is the north pole. This line represents 0 degree longitude or prime meridian. The right side represents eastern hemisphere and the left side represents western hemisphere. 30 degree west to 30 degree east. 30 degree west is 30 degree to the left of the prime meridian. You do not have to measure, just estimate. 30 degree east is 30 degree to the right of the prime meridian. The direction of travel is counterclockwise. Counterclockwise means we are traveling to the east. 150 degree west to 150 degree east. 150 degree west is 150 degrees left of the prime meridian, and 150 degree east is 150 degree right of the prime meridian. The closest route to travel from 150 degree west to 150 degree east is shown by the green curved line. We are traveling in a clockwise direction. Clockwise means we are traveling to the west. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking on the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.